Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2016 Jeanneau 58 yacht here in Marina del Rey, California. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular vessel has to offer. All right, so here we are looking at Nunya, the 2016 Jeanneau 58. This is a Philippe Rion design. This is a very powerful, stable offshore cruiser. Starting out the bow, you can see a large Lumar Delta anchor. We have the tack attachment point, second bow roller in place there. We also have an electric furler. At the very top of the mast, we have wind point, wind speed, wind direction, TV antenna. As we work our way down, the radar that is fully enclosed in a stainless steel cage to protect that from the head sail. We have the track phone and the carbon fiber spinnaker pole as well too. Obviously, this is in-mast furling. We have double-ended main sheet, inboard shrouds, large Jeanneau tracks here on the side. This particular vessel has been kept in really excellent condition. The teak decks are have just been sealed and treated. As we come aboard the vessel, you're looking at the Dodger. The Dodger itself has the Macrolon glass with a large stainless steel grab handle. So as you're boarding the vessel, something really nice to grab onto. Before I take you aft, I'm going to take you up forward, looking at these large Jeanneau tracks here. We have the main sheet that is double-ended, so it can be controlled from both starboard and port helm. As I mentioned, the inboard shrouds, we also have this inner staysail support as well too. So this is a nice retractable inner staysail that is a nice addition to offshore cruising. A forward bow cushion here for lounging. This does remove and stow down below when not in use. And then as we work our way up to the forward locker here, I'm gonna show you what this possesses. This actually has the downwind sail, but also possesses double bunk beds up here, additional storage, a full head and shower compartment. So this is an additional cabin, or this is considered like the crew cabin area. So a great use of space right here at the bow. Here we have a Lumar electric windlass. As we look down here, you can see this is a fully glassed in forward bulkhead. We also have a washdown as well too, and this is all chain. Really nice addition. All right, working our way back aft, you can see lots of opening hatches, large window that just really flood the salon with natural light. We even have running backs on this particular vessel as well too. So if you are carrying a downwind sail offshore, you have that just extra peace of mind with that. And then as you can see, when they're not in use, they can stow out of the way to keep it really nice. We also have attachment points right here on both starboard and port side. This is where a little boarding ladder could be installed. So, you know, with the high freeboard, this gives you a really nice access into the vessel. Now we're looking at something that the Jeanneau 57 just really excels in, not to mention its stability and performance, but just the livability, the size of this cockpit is truly something impressive. I mean, it really can accommodate lots of guests. It's a very comfortable offshore cruiser, as I mentioned. We have all the sheets and halyards leading in to the cockpit. So again, we have, you know, six electric winches on this boat, and it really is an easy boat to single hand and shorthand sail. Centrally located is the teak cockpit table. This has a storage. Just after that is a small little refrigerator compartment, and just a really beautiful high-end look to the vessel. As we work our way back aft, we have a dedicated storage life raft locker here, and we have access down into the dinghy garage. I have lots of pictures and videos of the dinghy garage, but this opens up and you can see how incredibly roomy and nice this is. The electric transom drops down, the dinghy itself just slides right out, and you can also use that as a beach platform in the back as well too. So it is very impressive and a nice you know, design feature on this. As I mentioned, we have six electric winches. So when you're sitting here at the starboard or port helm, you have controls for your Jeanneau sheet and the main sheet. The main sheet is right here behind you, and our Jeanneau sheets are right here in front of us. This is our Volvo throttle controls here. We also have 2,294 engine hours on this particular engine itself. This is the access to the quick bow thruster, windlass chain counter, And then again, you have really nice accessibility to be able to operate the electric furler right here at a push button. Then we also have our navigation lights, our multi-repeater, and our autopilot with a rudder reference built into it. Centrally located is the large glass mount display, Ray Marine. This is all touchscreen. This is the latest, and it is really amazing what it possesses. You can see we have full AIS, radar, GPS, everything that you would possibly need right here at your fingertips. And then at our port helm, we have the multi-repeater, depth, speed. We also have our fusion controls, our speaker lights, and then courtesy lights as well too. Large upgraded fusion sub here in the cockpit. And then we also have fusion speakers just aft of us as well too. All right, as we move on down below, one thing I wanna point out is the companionway door. This is really unique. They both slide open like an elevator entry. So this is really nice. They're counterbalanced, so they're never gonna slam on you. There is a locking mechanism if so desired, but this is a nice entry into the yacht. As we come down below the yacht, you're gonna be able to see just how voluminous this salon really is. Now, this is the light oak interior with the dark walnut floors, and it is absolutely beautiful. We have the nav station off to the starboard side, the galley off to the port side. And as we look at the galley, you're gonna see lots of storage, drawer access storage, subsoil storage. Again, we have so much here. This is one of two aft staterooms. As you can see, the leather wrapped doors, the leather inlay in this wood door is just absolutely beautiful here. We have a three burner stove and oven, tons of countertop space. This was like the first year that they actually did the lacquered countertop, you know, cabinets, which is really beautiful. These large opening salon windows that just flood this with so much natural light. We have the top loading refrigerator, small freezer compartment there, side loading access as well too, and then a full dedicated freezer. And again, all of this has just the shock absorber, you know, hinges. We have the microwave here, and it's just so much storage. All right, so the galley, double stainless steel sink. We also have like a dish, a drying rack here. Down below here, this is our waste, and then we have all of our utensils and stuff. These are also on self-closing drawer hinges as well too. Directly across from us is a nav station, but you can see this really nice easy access entry. Below the companionway steps here, this is engine access. So this gives us forward engine access. We also have from both starboard and port side and from behind access to the Volvo engine. What I want to show you here is our sea strainers. We have an upgraded Balmar alternator and then the ship's alternator. So there's a 12 and 24 volt alternator on this for both electrical systems that are found on this yacht. Below us right here, this is our generator access. So the generator itself is in a sound shield. I believe there's 444 hours on this generator. This is a Cummins Onan generator. Again, it's in its own sound shield, and then it has the sound shield all around it. So it is very quiet when in use. The nav station. Here we are looking at the nav station. It's forward facing, tons of room. Underneath the nav seat, you can see there's tons of storage here. We also have storage hanging locker behind us here. We have that really beautiful chocolate leather wrapped into it. We have our second Raymarine glass mat display. Then we have our quick instrumentation. So it's one switch for all of our navigation components. We are monitoring water, fuel, amperage in and out. We also have a Vectron battery monitor, a VHF. Behind us here, this is all of our main breakers. So this is our ship to shore, our air conditioning, all of our main breakers. We also have the inverter switch and the generator start stop switch here. All right, so I'm gonna take you behind us. And this is, again, one of two aft cabins that are identical. One thing that I really love about these aft cabins is that the beds themselves can actually slide together to make a large queen or almost king size bed. And then they can separate, as you can see here, and you have a nice little walkthrough, and they can make two single berths. We also have large opening hatch here, opening hatch here. This is all a cabinetry that will open up to give you additional storage. Nice opening port. 12-volt fans, 110, 12-volt outlets, its own air conditioning heating controls here as well too. And then you have access into the head and shower compartment. So this is a three cabin, three head, with crew cabin up forward. These are quiet flush electric toilets. Now these are the wet heads, and then the master has its separate shower. And as I mentioned, you have side access and access from behind the engine as well too. So it's very accessible, additional storage as well too. All right, so here we are walking into the salon. And as I mentioned, the salon is just very open. It's very large. This is a large salon table, so you can seat lots of people around it. We have its air conditioning heating controls on starboard and port side. And then this is also our Newport 700 Spectra water maker controls. Behind this panel is a little bit of storage all throughout. And then you have storage underneath all of the seating as well too. Here we have a nice settee here off to the port side. We have our own air conditioning heating controls for the port side of the salon. And then this lifts up, and then this centerpiece lifts up, and you have a whole nice bar access here. And then, as I mentioned, storage underneath all of the seating. Large flat screen television behind the cabinet. All right, here we have our Fusion stereo, and then we also have our Sony Blu-ray player. All right, let's walk up to the forward master cabin. And as we walk up, we have one step down here, and then you come into this massive forward cabin. It has a large hanging locker here, a desk vanity area, its own TV, you know, Sony player, the Fusion stereo controls, but a large cabin. This particular cabin has a center line, a queen size berth. We have easy access to both sides of the bed as well too, so it's very easy to make. We also have lots of lights, overhead opening hatches, additional speakers up here as well too. And then as we walk back, we have our own private head and shower compartment. As I mentioned, this one has the shower divider, so it is easy for that to kind of enclose the shower, so it keeps it nice and dry. We have the shower pump here at the base of it, Corian countertops, lots of mirrors, and again, the quiet flush Japsco electric toilets. But again, you look at the quality, the craftsmanship, the really nice thick doors, the beautiful hinges, and just so much storage that this vessel possesses. It truly is a really remarkable offshore cruiser. All right, so we covered a lot of boat in a short period of time. I hope you found it to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this 2016 Jeanneau 58 located in Marina del Rey, California, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. And if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this, showing you what's on the market, what's coming available, and hopefully I'm able to provide some additional information for you to really enjoy. Thank you again.